Alex Blessing, congratulations on your last fight. What's next for you?
I don't know. Next rest for me. And now I'm just waiting for my manager to ask him what's going on. I don't know. Now just enjoy my life.
Enjoying your life? Okay, I'm gonna ask you a question. Lomachenko Linares, break it down.
It's a really interesting fight. I got Lomachenko, but maybe this time it's not gonna be no mask because Linares is a really tough fighter. He's a bigger, he's motivated, and I'm expecting a challenging fight. Really interesting.
Yeah, Jorge said that he will not quit and he'll shut Lomachenko up. And also,
you know, all the guys was talking the same before the fight, and they eventually talking the completely different after the fight. We will see what's gonna happen this time, but I think it's not gonna be that easy like Lomachenko's previous fights. This is my opinion.
Also, Linares said that all his fans, their houses, that he's gonna win. You think it's smart thing to do?
I don't know what he's trying to do, or you know, kick Lomachenko from the balance. I mean, psychological balance, or just to sell this fight more expensive to, you know, like to bring more fans to watch this fight. I don't know what he's doing, but you know, all the most of the boxers talking some bullshit before the fight, and I think the most important what they're gonna say eventually after fight.
Vargas Broner.
Honestly, you just tell me this time. I heard the first time in my life that it's gonna happen.
It is. What is it? April 21st.
Oh, wow.
In New York.
You know, I think Vargas is a disciplined fighter. Broner is not, and but Broner is really talented. It really depends if Broner still spending a lot of time in the gym or just spending this time somewhere in the nightclub. So I don't know.
Hugo Centeno Charlo.
You told me some, you know, difficult names.
No, you don't know.
I know who's Charlo, but the first guy.
Yeah, Hugo Centeno is. Okay, okay.
I'm sorry.
Do you know Gervonta and Cuellar?
Yes.
You know those both?
Yes.
Okay, what do you think about those?
So they're gonna fight.
They're gonna fight on that card, main event. Broner Vargas and then Gervonta and Cuellar.
You know, for me, just like first thoughts which popping up in my mind is for Gervonta because he's a really skilled and talented fighter, but Cuellar is a good brawler, and if he like pull him in all this, you know, brawling, he has a good chances, I think.
You're a pound for pound list, you beat three fighters right now. Who is the best?
Lomachenko is the best right now. I would put you know, the boards with Crawford on the first place, but maybe Crawford more kind of like a proven because he already beat a lot of great champions. Lomachenko not yet, but I know he will. So first and two, Lomachenko Crawford, and the third one, I don't even know, maybe Anthony Joshua.
Anthony Joshua, so what do you think between him and Wilder?
You know, it will be a really interesting fight because Wilder on the first side seems like not really a skilled boxer, but you know, when you're fighting against a guy who hits like a horse, you know, it's all the time make you some difficulties. So you're supposed to be cautious, do not get a hard punch. And you can see his fight against a Kubinian guy. Kubinian was really skilled and a good fighter, but you know, with all this Wilder's power just neutralized all his skills, because when you're afraid of the strong punch, you know, like it's more difficult to work on your 100%, you know, abilities. So again, on my first side, I got Joshua because he is more experienced. He got a good fight against Vladimir Klitschko, and you know, like he's an Olympic champion. But also, how he could handle all the Wilder's crazy power, I don't know. If he gonna get a punch in the start of the fight, it's could be a good chances for Wilder. If not, I think if this fight gonna last more than 6 rounds, chances for Joshua really improving, you know, dramatically.
Canelo Triple G looks like the fight is not gonna happen because of Canelo's drug testing. Do you think it's fair if Canelo gets suspended for a certain amount of time? They're talking about 6 months.
I think it's definitely fair because I'm not really believe that all this banned substance came to Canelo's body because of some raw meat. It's bullshit. I don't think the guy who's a multimillionaire getting the meat from the some, you know, some stupid places or in somewhere in Taco Bell in Mexico. So I think it's fair, but I still not believe that this fight not gonna happen because I think all this organization is so corrupted and all their goal just to get as much as more money and to lose the really multi-million fight just because one of the guys being caught on doping. I don't think it's gonna happen. It's already gonna happen if Triple G refused to fight because of doping. But if they're gonna disqualify him or suspend, I think it's gonna be fair.
Alright, so there you have it. And tell everybody how to follow you on your social media.
Thank you. Follow me in Instagram, alex_gwozdyk. And you can find me in Facebook. It's also Alex Gwozdyk. Thank you.